ओके कॉन्सेप्ट फोर, नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट राइट डाउन कॉन्सेप्ट फोर प्रीवियस ईयर, कॉन्सेप्ट फोर प्रीवियस ईयर सेक्शन थ्री, कॉन्सेप्ट फोर प्रीवियस ईयर सेक्शन थ्री. ओके कॉन्सेप्ट थ्री प्रीवियस ईयर सेक्शन थ्री, सॉरी कॉन्सेप्ट फोर सेक्शन थ्री. हाँ अब बात समझो क्या होता है प्रीवियस ईयर मीन्स, ये वर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट है मैंने बोला ठीक है. द डेफिनेशन वी स्टार्ट विद द वर्ड मीन्स इज एग्जॉस्टिव डेफिनेशन, द डेफिनेशन वी स्टार्ट विद द वर्ड इंक्लूज इज इंक्लूसिव डेफिनेशन. ओके द मीन्स डेफिनेशन हैज टू बी अंडरस्टूड वेरी स्ट्रिक्टली in very strict manner. Okay, we call it literal manner. Literally what is written is the previous year. So they are saying previous year means financial year. That means in no case previous year can be calendar year. In account somebody must have told you that you may choose your accounting closing year. You must have seen many various questions which are having March ending, some questions are having December ending, some questions may have June ending. Okay. In income tax, you are not allowed to choose your year. Year we have already given. Year that you have to follow is financial year. Financial year starts at April, it ends on March. You don't have choice of changing this particular thing because previous year means you have to follow law as it is, no changes. Am I clear with this? Okay. Previous year means financial year. But which financial year, sir? Is it any random financial year? No. Financial year means, okay, previous year means financial year immediately, though some words are not clear. Okay. Financial year means, okay, previous year means a financial year immediately preceding the assessment year. So you people are studying for which assessment year? Can you tell me you people are studying for which assessment year? Hello, which assessment year? So PY 18-19 and then AY 19-20. You people are studying for AY 19-20. Immediately preceding financial year is the previous year. Previous year is the financial year immediately preceding financial year. Assessment year. Immediately preceding assessment year. So what is your assessment year? 1920. This will start at April 19. It will end on March 20. Iske pehle wala sir. Financial year that. It's not calendar year. Financial year. Kaun sa wala? 18-19. Wo previous year. Am I clear? I may repeat this 3-4 more time. But this is a very simple definition. Previous year means a financial year immediately preceding the assessment year. Write down section 3. Write down with me only section 3 and write down this also. Previous year 18-19, assessment year 19-20. Next concept, concept 4, concept 5. Concept 5, assessment year. Assessment year means, concept 5, assessment year means, again means, a period of 12 month. Assessment year means a period of 12 month commencing on first day of April every year. Okay, commencing on first day of April every year. All right, can I tell you story, one small story about it? All right, so this is about Mahabharata. I guess majority people are having basic understanding about Mahabharata and all. and how Krishna was born. All right, so it was like, you know, many tragedies happened during his birth only. He was supposed to be killed by his own uncle, okay, because someone has told his uncle, no, Kans mama, that the eighth child of his own sister will become a reason for his own death, okay. So this was something that happened. So he started like, you know, putting them in their own some jail kind of thing, all right. And the moment first child were born, what he has done?
He killed.
He killed. But the intention was not to kill him, because which child should be killed?
Eight one.
Okay. So I don't understand this mythology. Sometimes they are so much complicated in nature. First of all, if Kans was like wrong person, if he was a villain kind of person, and if Krishna was supposed to take a birth, it should have government or God should have allowed him to take a birth without intimating him. Why are you intimating villain that someone is going to come this world and then he will kill you? Alright? But God has this kind of plan. No, God intimated him that, okay, this guy will come, eight child, he will kill you, okay. Now in Mahabharata and any mythological serial that you people have watched, Narad Muni has played wild role, okay. His role was very simple. He has no powers, okay. If you have seen, Narad Muni had no powers. He was not having any special powers like Hanumana and other people, alright. So he was very simple guy. He was a messenger, alright. He was supposed to disturb things which are going smoothly. And if certain things are disturbed, then make them smoothly. Alright? He was just messenger. He was just a messenger. His responsibility was to deliver, alright, right message to wrong person and wrong message to right person. This is what he has been doing all over Mahabharata. So he came to Kans and said, okay, you are going to kill only eighth child of
Devaki.
Alright? How do you know that 8 is from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? Or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? Forward, ascending order or descending order? If you make them stand in one line, even first one is the 8th one. Then consider, okay, I will kill 2, first and last. Then Narad Muni said, then how do you know if all of them are standing in circle? Because you can start at anyone, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You understand, if you make 8 students standing in a row, or at least circle, in a row, yes, first and last. But if you stand in circle, how do you count? You can start counting at any person and it may end on any person. And how do you trust gods? Gods told you 8-1 is going to kill. Why are you trusting it? Don't trust it. Alright, it's very risky to take chance. Alright, so kill every child which is about to born. Now, Kans mama could have killed it, small child, very nicely, you go and just, you know, these two fingers also you can kill. But he was having, you know, kind of strategies, good policies, okay. Take the child, throw it on wall. Alright, it should blast like fruit, okay. Enjoy, like. Now there was a story about it, why it has happened. I'm not going into that story. I'm asking you the same question so far as the definition is concerned, assessment year. So they said assessment year means period of 12 months. That is for sure. Yeah. Assessment year is period of
12 months.
That is for sure. But then which question comes to your mind? Which 12 month? Because 12 month from January to December, they are also 12 month.
Yeah.
April to March also 12 month. Are June to July, July to June is also 12 months. So which 12 month is the assessment year? If they say assessment year, it means period of 12 month. If they stop here, there are a lot of possibilities. In fact, there are 12 possibilities of 12 month. Therefore, they had to define which 12 month. It is a complete period of 12 month which has to commence on 1st April. Then you tell me by using your senses, when will it end? 31st March. So what I am trying to tell you here is that, very simple concept, a previous year may not be of 12 month, but assessment year has to be of 12 month. Previous year may or may not be of 12 month, okay, because whenever we say year means how many months? 12. But here assessment year, they are very much clear. Assessment year means a period of 12 months commencing on first day of April every year. So every year, 1st April, what happens? Assessment year start, new assessment year start. So your assessment year, you people are eagerly waiting for it to start. Which date? 1st April 2019. If it starts at 19, 1st April 19, obviously it is going to end on 31st March 2020 because it has to be period of 12 months. You cannot increase it, you cannot decrease it. In accounts, you have choice of increasing your accounting period. It can be 9 months or it can be 15 months. Hello? That is in accounts. Why income tax is trying to write this in very much detail? Because you people learn account also. You should not follow concepts of accounts in taxation because taxation is a law. Accounts is a management decision. Taxation is a law. For you also it is same, for me also it is same, for any random company or firm or person in this world, income tax law remains same. Accounting year, you may follow your own year, I may follow my own year. I don't even want to follow year. I want to close my balance sheet at 6 months. Will you stop me? No. My company, my balance sheet, I can do any shit in my balance sheet. You do in your balance sheet. You understand? This is how it works. But in income tax, no. This is created by law. It has to be followed by law. Am I clear?
Yes.
Alright. Then you said, sir, previous year can be less than 12 months. What is the example of that? You tell me, if you become CMA in June attempt, okay, result will come in August. Alright. On 1st August, you started, or on 1st September, you started your firm. Hello? Okay, so your firm was not in existence from April. Your firm was in existence from 1st September. So for you, previous year is 1st September to 31st March. You must close on 31st March. Because on 1st April, what will start? Hello? Assessment. So assessment year will start for sure on 1st April. And before that, you have to close your previous year. Then you will say, sir, it is not 12 months. We don't want previous year of 12 months. It can be lesser than. And this will happen only once in your lifetime.
Yes.
Balance every year, business will be there from April to March, April to March. But first year of business, new source of income, new business, what will happen? From date of incorporation to 31st March. End is fixed. Starting you may choose for first year. You understand? Sir, what if I started my business on 25th March? What will be my previous year? 6 days. You have to close your books of account by 6 days. Alright, 25th March to 31st March. Because it will end on 31st March. Sir, what if I start my business on 31st March? You must close your business on 31st March for that year. Income of that day, expense of that day, profit of that day, you have to pay tax on that day. In assessment day. Because on 1st April, which year will start? Assessment, that is for sure. Okay, that is fixed. Starting of assessment year is fixed. Before that, you have to close your previous year, that is 31st March. A previous year may or may not start at 1st April. For existing business, it will be from 1st April. For new business, from the date of incorporation to from date of incorporation to 31st March. Okay, write it down. Is it there? Wait. Concept, what is the concept number? Concept 6. Concept 6, period of previous year. Write down, I'm dictating. Concept 6, period of previous year. Do not copy as it is. This is last year, so do not copy as it is. I'm dictating you guys. Okay? Concept 6, period of previous year. Written it. Under that, write down normally. Period of previous year, normally. This is MCQ, it comes in MCQ. Therefore, I am putting this much energy into it. Normally, okay, 1st April, write down, normally 1st April to 31st March. Normally, 1st April to 31st March. Next line, take exceptions like this. Take arrow and write down exception. Take one down arrow and write down exception. There are two exceptions, new source of income or new business or profession. New source of income or new business or profession. New source of income or new business or profession. Okay. In this case, previous year equal to in reading. Previous year equal to PY equal to in reading, use reading. Okay. PY equal to date of commencement to 31st March. Previous year equal to PY equal to date of commencement to 31st March. Date of commencement to 31st March. Okay. All right. Next concept. Now, this is the rule of taxation. Concept. What is the concept again? Next concept. Concept. Concept 7. This is the rule of taxation. Okay. What is the name of this concept? Rule of taxation. Now, please understand what is the rule. Income earned in a previous year shall be assessed in. Hello. Shall be assessed in assessment year. Income earned in previous year shall be assessed in assessment year. So you earn in 1918-19 and you assess in 1920. Earn in 1819, assess in. This is the law. This is law. This is main rule. Okay. Earn in 1819. Okay. And assess in 1920. This is the law. You understood this is the law. Okay. I am going to teach you exception to law. First you have to write the law. Law is that you earn in this year, pay in next year. Alright. But there are 5 exceptions to law. Okay. And those exceptions is income earned in previous year shall be assessed in previous year itself. So your PY will become AY. Ordinary circumstances, PY is something different and AY is next year. PY, next year AY. PY, next year AY. You understand? In these circumstances, in 5 situation, PY is AY. Previous year is assessment year. And therefore here I say, earn in 1819 and pay also in or assess also in 1819 itself. You understood this much? Okay. First write down these two, then I will teach you section wise. Write down these two. Rule, concept 7. Concept 7. Rule of taxation. Concept 7, rule of taxation. And under that, write down this paragraph. Income earned previous year shall be assessed in assessment year. This is the language your charging section is using. Income earned in previous year shall be assessed in assessment year. AC. First AC. First. Okay. Write down these things. Earn in 1819, assess in 1920. Below that. So you will understand it. Earn in 1819, assess in 1920. Next line, write down exception. You may write down exception word in reading. Exception. Income earned in previous year shall be assessed in previous year itself. Earn 1819, assess 1819. All right. All right, let's go ahead. Here itself you have to write those five exceptions, okay, section wise that too. The first section in this series is section 172, okay. Section 172 talks about shipping business of non-resident. NR means? Non-resident, okay. So this is India, okay, this is Sri Lanka. One ship came to India, this is the ship, all right. One ship came to India and it loaded container from India. It has already loaded container from Sri Lanka and it is loading container from India and then it will go to USA. Okay, two or three days only it will stay in India. Hello, is that ship earning income from India? Some containers are loaded from India. Are they earning income from India? That ship is owned by non-resident, some African company or Canadian company. It's not Indian ship. Okay, do you trust that they will come in next year to pay taxes of this year? So what is the solution? Give me solution. First pay tax and then only you are allowed to leave our port. Okay, first pay tax, you earn income, you pay tax now, and then after paying tax only we will give you tax clearance certificate and then only you are allowed to leave our port. Otherwise you are not allowed to go outside India. You have to stay there. Alright, it is on that real time basis because we don't trust you guys. You are a non-resident. You may come in next year, you may not come next year. Hello. Yes. Therefore, we are taking tax in that year itself. Okay, therefore 172, shipping business of non-resident. Next, please understand, 174, person living in India. This can be a Vijay Malia uncle's example. Alright, you have done so many cons in India, okay, so many things in India, so many wrongdoings in India, and now you are traveling to abroad, okay. Which country, if you tomorrow if you also do some big scam, I assume some of you may do, alright, where will you go? In which country will go, which country will provide us protection? Switzerland, no? Hello? England, you will go obviously to England. Why? Who told you about England? Hello? Vijay Malia uncle, where is Vijay Malia uncle? In England, Lalit Modi, England, Lalit Modi, England. So all these people who are doing something wrong at very big level, they are going to? And India is unable to take them back from England because England is following some different laws, we are following some different laws. Alright, default here is not default in that country and therefore that country is also having very strong laws and they have right to protect their own citizens. Alright, people who are staying in that country. So many things have happened. So at least you should thankful to the Vijay Malia uncle, alright, with due respect, that at least we know, alright, where to go after doing something wrong in India. Alright. So you are also standing in airport by 20-30 bags, okay, you don't have return ticket. Because whenever people fly abroad, they take a return ticket. They take visa of limited days. You are going there and that you are going to England. Don't you think that income tax department will have certain suspicion about you? Like you are traveling with 15-20 bags, there is no return ticket. That you may not come back. You will come back. You may, but you may not. Why to take risk? So in airport, if you go, you can see immigration department, and next to immigration department, there is a custom officers and there are income tax officers 24/7. All right. So if they feel that you are leaving India by not paying taxes in India and you may not come back, this is their call. They may allow you to go, they may not. Okay. If they feel that you are not going to come back, they are going to take your tax on airport itself. Otherwise, you are not allowed to take that flight. It's very strict. Okay. So person leaving India, Tata Baba, Vijay Malia uncle is the example. Okay. Joint ventures. You have done joint venture accounting in childhood. Yes. All right. So joint ventures means entities create for some intention, some purpose. When that purpose is achieved, you shut down the entity. Do you think we will allow you to shut down the entity without paying taxes because next year there won't be any venture? No. So if you are shutting down in current year, first you pay tax, you clear your obligation and then only you dissolve your firm or venture, whatever you have created. Okay. Yes. Next. Okay. 175, person transferring property to evade taxes. What is this word?
Evade.
It's EV. It's not ER. Okay. Evade taxes. Evade. Tax evasion. Okay. I will write it clear. Evade. Okay. Person or you can, instead of evade, evade is very big word. Okay. Let's say avoid. You understand avoid?
Yes.
Avoid taxes. Okay. So he just wanted to avoid taxes. Okay, evade is after proving only we say that he is a tax evader, it's like convicted. मान ले कि तुम टैक्स के चोर हो. ओके, अवॉइड मीन्स ट्राइंग टू अवॉइड. ओके, ट्राइंग टू इवेड. सो समथिंग लाइक दिस. सो पर्सन ट्रांसफरिंग प्रॉपर्टी टू अवॉइड टैक्स. सो आई नो दैट इनकम टैक्स इज गोइंग टू रेड माई प्रीमाइसेस. ओके, इन दैट मूवी ऑल्सो दे हैव शोन इन रेड. ओके, बिफोर रेड दे कॉल देयर पार्टीज एंड इन्फॉर्म देम रेड इज गोइंग टू हैपन एंड ऑल. इन ऑर्डिनरी केसेस दिस इज हैपन, बट इन दैट रेड व्हेन अजय देवगन टेक द रेड ऑन दिस व्हाइट हाउस. ओके, इवन इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर्स वेर नॉट नोइंग दैट दे आर गोइंग टू रेड ऑन व्हाइट हाउस. एट लास्ट मोमेंट ही टेल दैट वी आर रेडिंग ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रीमाइसेस. Alright, so they keep it very secret because income tax officers also know, commissioners also know, if you tell them that we are going to raid these people, then there will be setting. Department will start certain setting and department will inform that person that raid is about to come. So you adjust everything. Hello, alright. So what that person will do, he know that now raid is about to come, he will try to transfer his all properties. Bank balance to one person's account, legal ownership of house to someone else, and then income tax come, he will stand like a Shah Rukh Khan. Take me. I have nothing. Or take wherever you want to take. So that is not a purpose of income tax department. Income tax department wanted to recover taxes. Therefore, they are raiding your premises. And if you have transferring property, if you started transferring property, then they are not going to wait for assessment here. The moment they see movement in your bank account, they have right to freeze your bank account. Even you are not allowed to access bank account. Okay, the moment they see some suspicious moment, freeze. Accounts will be freeze. Okay, and then they will take tax from you, not in assessment year, immediately. Okay, so that is this. Last 176 is the discontinuance of any business. Okay, that was only for joint ventures. This is for any business. Sandesh sir will teach you liquidation of company, dissolution of partnership firm. Alright, in that he will show you that a priority that we give in dissolution, you understand dissolution, alright, or liquidation of company, in closing down any business, the first priority that we give it to income tax department as well. Alright, if there are certain tax obligations left, then you must pay first taxes and then only you can pay to your secured debtors, secured creditors, unsecured creditors and then owners. So there are steps. Income tax get priority in all those payments. Okay, that is also, they are not going to wait for assessment year again. If you are shutting down business in this year, we have to take recover taxes in this year. Am I clear? Alright, so write down this five exceptions along with section. Can you pause it?